last 1 hour without me.
You gonna be a little bitch about it?
Tell us where your husband is.
You lost my husband? That is your job, motherfucker.
The only way Bryce and Kincaid don't make it so they kill each other first.
If you wouldn't mind, the gun.
Yo! You about done?
Okay, on three.
One.
My bad. You're bad.
Yeah, we matched. Jamal Finkley. Jamal Finkley, Black Trait TV. That's all. First, I've always wanted to be your cucaracha.
Oh, that's the new pickup line.
All right, all right. But it's great seeing y'all on film together. I mean, Sam, you seem to pair up so well with everybody that you work with. But how was the chemistry on set? Because I know, like, your character had real beef with Ryan Reynolds' character. Is there ever real beef on set with any fellow actors that on movies you worked on? Does it happen? Yeah. They just get past it and...
Some of them do, some of them don't, you know? But I never had real beef with another actor on camera. I've watched other actors do it, but no.
Yeah.
He's like any other workplace.
Yeah, it's a workplace.
Some people
get
along, some people don't.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know in, you know, all these years of acting that you guys have been traveling to amazing places, and this movie goes to Bulgaria and Amsterdam. Can you talk about, like, some of the, like, most amazing locations that you've had to, you know, that you've been able to travel to because of your work?
She probably shot on more exotic locations than I have, but I think my favorite was always Cape Town. I love
mine
shooting
too.
In Cape Town. That's awesome. That's such an awesome place to shoot.
Because
Cape Town's amazing.
Yeah, I love Cape Town.
Yeah. And actually, Joburg, you know, South Africa has been that place for me. And last year, Vietnam, when we did Kong in Vietnam, because it's just so otherworldly and, you know, so peaceful, and the people are so dope, so cool. It's just a great place to be.
Wow. Me, South Africa and the Bahamas is kind of fantastic. You know, you go diving.
It just sounds like too much. Sounds like too much work for me in the Bahamas. Like, I would have no peace in the Bahamas. Yeah.
Transport is in there.
Is that blood, dude?
What the?
Know how long I've been waiting for this? Oh, no, I'm not gonna look.
No, mother!
Whoa.
Let's talk about this.
Well, it's been, I guess, 30 years since she was on set for School Days and 30 years since Uncle Tom's Cabin has come out. You got so many movie titles now that you've worked on as an actor. Has the casting process changed for you? When you look back way back then when you first started to, like, now when, I mean, I guess directors know they're getting, like, so many, you know, great things from you.
Well, everything changes when you stop auditioning, right? Uncle Tom's Cabin, that was a movie I auditioned for. I was actually working on a Cosby show. I was Bill Cosby's stand-in when I auditioned for that movie and got that job. And Felicia was my wife. And wow. I literally didn't even speak to her on set because I was trying to be quiet on the Cosby show. And then I get down there and I'm playing her husband and we're interacting. So she really didn't know I was like an actor until all of a sudden she got there and was like, they cast you as my husband. I was like, yeah. So there's that. But once you stop auditioning, everything changes.
Yeah.
And I don't think that process has changed in Hollywood. You know, hopefully a lot of actors have made it through this. Like last year when I was watching Mahershala win his Academy Award, it's like now the job changes because I'm sure he's been going through the audition process and people sending him stuff. But now he has a chance to create his own career arc by having an opportunity to make choices on the kinds of things that he wants to do and the kinds of roles he wants to do and put himself out there as for people, or to show the versatility of his talent, you know, by doing a lot of different characters. And, you know, that's a blessing when you get to that point. And it's also a curse, because you can pick a lot of bad movies, and next thing you know, you know, that happens too, right?
And a lot of bad movies, the next thing you know, it's over. I mean, it's like life. Because
it's all about all about putting asses in seats. You got to pick movies that put asses in seats.
Yeah, there's a great scene in this movie where you have this, where it's this bar fight, and you just like you're tearing into everybody, and you can see Kincaid, Sam's character, fall in love with you. Can you remember the time when you first fell in love with acting, and what was it that did that?
It
for
was
you?
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. It was not acting that I fell in love with. Funny enough, I'm not gonna lie to you. It was the film industry, because I was a little girl and I saw this movie and I said, wait a minute. In this life, there is one tunnel, one place that exists where anything can happen. The river can be out of chocolate, you know, the flowers out of candy, and you can chew a gum and you know, levitate and then burp yourself back down to earth. And it kind of dawned on me that through film, you could break every rule, and I don't like rules of nature, of time and space. And so I fell in love with that portal, you know, that you could enter.
Well, thanks. I've been in love with you guys on screen for your whole careers, as long as I've known you on screen.
Right. So
thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Appreciate you.